guys, so we're here with our director, Miss Frick Schaefer. She is the true belle of this show this year. She is our overall director and musical director, and I'm so happy to interview you today. So
thank you, Sydney.
We're going to start off with our first few questions.
Okay.
So number one, why did you and the other show directors choose to do Beauty and the Beast? What is so appealing about the show?
Yeah, we picked this one. We thought it was a good comeback show. It's got a lot of that like namesake notoriety. Nothing really draws in a crowd like Disney. Yeah. And that's kind of what we're looking to do this year. Rebuild, restructure, let everybody know we're back. We're back in a big way. So that really drove the decision. And just a show that's really wholesome, really family oriented. We can get the elementary kids involved and all of that stuff as well. So definitely, that was a big driving force for it.
Definitely. Yeah, we're all very excited for the show. How does it feel to be doing a show again after COVID? All the waiting and the gathering of information, it's finally here.
Yeah, it feels like there's a lot of pressure for it to be successful and to go well. But also it's just like, it's kind of a positive pressure where it's like, there's so much momentum going into it. The directing team is so excited. We're all so ready to get back on the stage again. And it's something that I'm really excited to showcase people who've been waiting in the wings for several years now who have really good theater chops.
How does audition week feel for you? Are you just as excited as all the other students?
Yes, definitely. I definitely was like having a hard time sleeping last night. Had a lot of like, it brings back my own feelings of auditioning. So it's like, I totally see your side of it as performers and like what you've been doing these past few weeks to prepare. And then just like the anticipation of this day. But then as a director now, it's like being in the auditorium, like you start to feel the energy, like something is about to go down here. That's really special. So I think the audition thing is, it's becoming very real. Also in the fact that I'm truly directing. And I think until this point, I was like, yeah, sure, directing sounds great. But today it's like, oh man, like this is a lot of responsibility and we have a lot to sort out these next 3 days. But it's like an exciting challenge to look at everyone that comes in and start to put them in the pieces of the puzzle. And I'm super excited, but yeah, I feel the nerves and like all of that stuff today.
Auditions happen so quickly and there are so many talented people to be heard. How do you make those decisions for lead roles? Is it all nerve-wracking and overwhelming, or is it exciting finally seeing the show come together and like set in place? Like you know who's gonna be which role. The show kind of comes together.
Yeah, I think it's a little bit of A, a little bit of B. Sometimes someone comes in and as soon as they open their mouth, you're like, that's Belle. Like there's no one else, that's it. Sometimes it's really that simple. And other times different directors have different opinions and we end up talking, negotiating, trying to figure out how people will fit. But I think on both sides of it, sometimes it is that like real simple, straightforward thing where everyone's gut tells them like, that's the right person for that role. And then there's other times where it's like, you can see them here, you can see them there. And that's something that's great for callbacks, just to get those really nitty gritty, like scripted details, see the chemistry between people. That's something day one of audition you don't get, because you literally have one person up, they leave, the next person comes in. So as far as that goes, callbacks really helps with that process to sort out people that were like, we could see them in three roles or four roles, and we really don't know which is their strong suit until we get a little bit more information at callbacks.
If there are any students who miss auditions or decide to join past the audition date, what should they do? What parts of the show may they join if they miss the audition dates?
Yeah, that's something I think we're gonna have to figure out case by case with the directing team. Because I definitely want to put people in when they'll be successful. I think adding them in too late could be really tough for them to try to pick up on everything. So it may just be like a limited scenes kind of a deal or something like that, just to make sure that they feel successful being part of the show and not just kind of thrown into choreography and dance and blocking and all of the different things that we do. It really is like an all-encompassing art form and takes a lot of work and a lot of practice, and that's something too that you want to honor the people who have been there and who have been working really hard. So to throw somebody in at the last minute and they have to teach them all of that stuff is also a burden on the performers who've been learning all this time and now have somebody else that they're kind of like responsible for. So definitely case by case for sure. And it depends how far along we are in the show run and things like that to see if we can include people later on.
Right. Thank you so much for being interviewed. Sure. I'm really looking forward to the show. And yes. I know everybody else is. I'm really glad we could do this interview. If you're not sure if you're going to do the show, join. Ms. Fritz Schaefer is an excellent director, and we're really looking forward to the show, and I'm hoping that the community is as well. Thank you again.
Thanks for having me. I appreciate it. Thanks for the opportunity to talk about what we're doing.